Well, Pedro, this is something you've wanted for a long time, I know, to be a manager, and it's early, but what does it feel like to be able to run your own spring training, have this club, and start to mold it into the vision that you have?
You know what? It feels really good, and it's not just the club, the organization, it's the staff that we were able to assemble. There was a lot of things that, you know, over time I felt like if I ever got an opportunity, I would definitely put in place, and bringing a staff like this, like I got, and working with them on a daily basis and seeing our plan being executed on the field is really good. And then on top of that, we got great players. This is a good ball club, and I'm excited.
You've had that time to think about how you want to execute this. What kind of identity do you envision to have in this club?
I just want to work hard, and let's see what happens, you know, when we put the work in and we attack the details and the fundamentals. Over time, I think the identity will start kind of molding itself. But right now, all I want to do is focus on working hard and with a lot of energy.
Something you said the other day when full camp started was you can't win a championship in spring training, but you can lose one. What do you mean by that?
I just feel like if you're not prepared, for April, and you fundamentally you lose games because of the fundamentals and the details. I just feel like, you know, I've seen it over and over again in September. You need that one game or two games that you lost in April. So I know you can't win a championship in spring training, but I damn well sure don't want to lose one.
Who are some of your biggest influences in life? Could be in baseball, outside of life, and things that you're trying to take from those people or things that you've read or watched that will help you in this job?
Outside of baseball, you know, my dad, my grandfather, those are the ones that kind of laid the foundation for me and molded me into the man that I am right now. In baseball, I've been lucky. You know, I've had some good people around me that have taken their time with me to help me grow. Guys like Ted Simmons, John Bowles, Rafael Colon. I mentioned George Brett. I'm so grateful to those guys because they didn't have to do some of the things that they did. And just recently having conversations with Jimmy Leland and Tony La Russa, you know, and those guys have taken interest in my career, and I'm so appreciative of that.
You weren't here last year, obviously, but something the guys would tell us was there was maybe some complacency that set in, especially being a team that had the expectations of a World Series contender, a division winner. The expectations externally have changed a little bit. I know they haven't internally, but can that help a group to kind of, hey, we didn't reach our goal last year, and now this year we kind of, you know, setting everything back to square one and not having those big expectations on us? Can that help a group?
You know what? I wasn't here last year. I don't know the energy. I don't know, you know, anything about the clubhouse from last year. All I know is that we've moved forward. We're talking about 2023. We're talking about just how we're going to go about our business. But the expectations, they're not gone. You know, this is basically the same team that had those high expectations last year. So, and we're not hiding from those either. We know what's at stake. We know the expectations. But I don't want to get too far ahead of the game here. We got to get through spring training, and then we just got to focus on one game at a time because this thing can change really quick.
What did show you that guys like Loy and Lucas Giolito have changed their bodies? They've really worked hard this offseason and dedicated themselves not just on the field but off the field too.
Yeah, those guys have done a great job, and it just shows how committed they are to their craft, how committed they are to this organization, and that ball club in there. And I'm really excited to watching those guys perform.
And how does Pedro Grifol unwind? What are some things you like to do to get your mind away from baseball?
You know what? This is a funny and controversial question because my answer, nobody likes my answer. And I don't have many hobbies. I do this and I spend time with my family. I just unwind, you know, just going home and just relaxing and thinking about tomorrow, really. Tomorrow's work day. So I know people don't like to hear that because they want me to go fishing and golf, and I don't do any of that stuff. This is what I do, and when I have time off, I spend it with my family.
Baseball 24/7, family as well.
No doubt.
It's fair enough.
You got it.